Joining me now, political communications expert, partner at Maslansky and Partners, Lee Carter. Republican campaign strategist, Fox News contributor, Tony Sayegh. Thank you both for being here. This is an extraordinary night because we're looking at these polls closing. The electoral maps, as Arne in Michigan was just here talking about the Fox News map, this thing is getting awful tight.
It is awfully tight. And I was just spending all this time looking at the numbers, trying to figure out what's going to happen. And there are some critical states that have turned today. The race is tightening. We have Pennsylvania is now between less than 2 points for Clinton. This is something that's absolutely unheard of. Florida has flipped to Donald Trump again. It's gone back and forth.
I guess I give away my preference in this race when I laugh like that. But I mean, it is remarkable. It looked like Pennsylvania a little over a week ago was solidly Clinton.
Pennsylvania, Lou, and include Michigan into that. I mean, look where all the big Clinton surrogates are tonight and tomorrow. President Obama, Bill Clinton himself, Hillary Clinton, they're in the state of Michigan. Donald Trump spending a lot of time there as well. He's going to be there tonight. So now you have two humongous electoral scores in Michigan and Pennsylvania, 20 and 18 electoral votes respectively, up for grabs. So when you talk about what does Donald Trump need beyond those critical swing states that we already talk about a lot, North Carolina, Florida, Ohio, he could solve a lot of problems winning one of those two states between Pennsylvania and Michigan, and that's why you see the Clinton campaign extremely worried this 11th hour.
And the Clinton campaign is quick to talk about, well, our ground game is better, this is, you know, all of this. But most people don't realize you're not talking about a lot of incremental points improvement through simply a ground game. What Donald Trump has demonstrated is an immense appeal to the American voter, talking about the values and the goals that matter and the issues that matter most to them. And you're talking about Hillary Clinton, mm-hmm. who is, as he says, I mean, it's demonstrable. It is empirical. She is the most corrupt presidential candidate in the modern era of this country.
So she might have ground game. There's no question that she has the infrastructure, the operations, but she doesn't have the message and she doesn't have the hearts of people. When the thing that I am looking at the most is the enthusiasm of supporters, and she has a 10-point deficit in enthusiasm. Enthusiasm is the thing that's going to drive people to the polls.
What do you think that's understated, 10 points?
Look, I think when you really look at the deep crosstabs of this election, Hillary Clinton needs a Barack Obama-style turnout from 2012, which was less, by the way, than 2008. She's not getting it. African Americans are turning out by less significantly in North Carolina and Florida, according to early voting. And in Ohio, Lou, she's even almost within single digits of Donald Trump with women. That's not good for her. And young voters. Why do you think the president today, President Obama, is campaigning at University of Michigan, Ann Arbor? They were at University of Pittsburgh today. This is because they're not getting that same millennial enthusiasm for Hillary Clinton that Barack Obama was able to get with this message of hope and change.
Where is enthusiasm for Hillary Clinton? Where is it demonstrable? In what demographic? Amongst what group? Because I don't see it.
The celebrities?
Elites.
Elites.
The people with vested interest in keeping the status quo support her, which is why when we talk about Michigan and Pennsylvania, think about how Democrats dismissively talk about Donald Trump supporters. They're deplorable. These are undereducated white people. Barack Obama once called this kind of group of people the bitter clingers onto guns and religion. Right. Well, guess where the bitter clingers, deplorables live? Western Pennsylvania and Northern Michigan. And guess what? Two states are right on the verge of voting Republican for the first time since 1988. Michigan and Pennsylvania.
Well, let me just say this to all of our college-educated white people or whoever they are. if you're demonstrating a certain lack of education. You may have gotten a degree, but if this is where you come down with that college degree, you're not paying attention, or you're not processing, or incapable, or have just horribly tortured values.
And I just also think that it's really important right now when you look at how many people think the system is broken, that Washington, D.C. is broken.
Where would they ever get that idea?
When people think that, how can you vote for Hillary Clinton if that's what you believe? Because she's not going to go down there and fix it. This works to her advantage. And that's one of the things that I hear from voters over and over again. Whether or not they like Donald Trump, they say we need something different down there.
What do you